Let us start commercial correspondence chapter 4, layout of business letters. Business letters are different from social letters. As all the business letters are written in the same format, uniformity can be maintained and the letter can be written and understood faster. Various parts of business letters generally are as follows. Keeping writing of business letter as base, the letter can be divided into two parts, regular part of a letter and occasional part of the letter. The regular part of a letters are heading, date, inside address, salutation, body of a letter, complimentary clause and signature. Here is a specimen showing regular part of the business letter. You can see how the heading is put at the center, and towards your right side you can find the email and date, and towards your left side on the top you can put phone number, or you can put the phone number just above the inside address followed by salutation. Then again you will have the body of the letter, introduction paragraph, middle paragraph, concluding paragraph, and then towards your right side at the last complimentary clause with the signature below that. Let us learn the occasional or the optional parts of the business letter. First, personal and other notation. Second, attention line. Third, subject line. Fourth, enclosure. Fifth, carbon copy notation. Sixth, identification line. Seventh, mailing instruction. And eighth, postscript. Now you can see the specimen which shows the occasional part of a business letter. Difference between the specimen of the regular and the occasional part, you can identify it. Just below the date, you have the personal or other notation. Similarly, after the inside address, you have attention line and subject line. At the last, you can see towards the left side, you can put the enclosure or the CC, that is a carbon copy, or the identification line or mailing instruction or postscript, and towards your right side, your complimentary clause with the signature. Let us now discuss the regular part of a business letter in detail. The letter without letterhead creates a lot of confusion in the mind of the reader. The writer of the letter can be easily known with the help of a letter hood. Along with the name and the address written below, the name also helps to identify the writer of the business letter. Now, what are the matters related to letterhead? First is, whose heading should be written? The name of the person or firm writing the letter should be written in the middle of the page, at the top, or on the right-hand side of the letter. Second is address. The address should be mentioned either at the top, in the middle, after heading, or it can be written on the right hand side. Full address along with PIN code should be written. Third is mention type of business. If needed, the type of business being carried out should be mentioned below the name of the firm in bracket. Fourth, other matters along with address. Along with other matters like email, fax number, telephone number, website, etc. if we have, then it should be mentioned. It will be easy for the reader also. These matters can be written on right hand side or left hand side of the letter. Fifth is heading as per firm. If it is a private company, then it is important to write PVG.LTD, that is private limited, after the name of the company. Similarly, if it is a public company, then you have to write LTD, which should be after the name of the company. For example, sales department, finance department, etc. If the department is also mentioned, then it will be easy. Then we have attractive heading. To make the letter attractive, heading is written in artistic way by using artistic or that attractive designs. For these, professional help is seeken. Seventh is symbol or logo. If the firm writing the letter is to create its own identity, then it will have a symbol or sign, that is a trademark, then that logo should be used. Care should be taken to avoid unnecessary things from heading. It should be kept simple and easy. In present days, many firms write the related line below the name of the firm. The heading should be such that all the matters should be clearly legible. Generally, black or blue color heading looks attractive. Care should be taken that heading should not occupy more than 1/5 space of the paper. You can see the example also. Two examples are given where the letterhead, you can see how it has been written. Date. Generally, date is written on right hand side after heading. various methods of writing dates are there. One is British method, the second is American method. According to the British method, in England, while writing date, day of the month is written first, followed by month or year. For example, 15th July 2020, 15th July, 2020. This method is also known as ordinal method. Now in American method, July 15, 2020, month is written first, then the date and then the year. This method is also known as cardinal method. Next important goes to the full stop. Many a time comma is not put after day and full stop after year while writing date. It is advisable to make use of a comma and full stop. Similarly, while writing the name of the month, it should be written full, not in a short form. Like January, the entire spelling should be written, not J-A-N. And for writing the year, all the four digits must be mentioned, not in any form of short form. Second point is inside address. The person or firm to whom the letter is written, its address is written as inside letters. It is written on left hand side of the letter after keeping the margin space. Full stop and comma are used for inside address. The name of the person to whom letter is written on the top, followed by the designation and address. The word used inside the letter or the address for showing courtesy are for males, Mr. or Mr. like Mr. Ramesh. For unmarried female, Miss, M-I-S-S. So you can see above to whom and how the salutation is to be used with an example.